Now coming to the final points, I don't know how many will be covered there. I think there's just 10 minutes, but I'll try my best to cover as many as possible. So what the I see is everyday versus, you know, everyday products and one-off products. Okay, so there are certain products which are transactional, right? You know, suppose a bill recharge, right? You know, or you know, your utility payments or your mobile company one where you're checking just the data. Those are one-off products. There really does not it, you know, the jarring things matter. Something that sticks out, you know, something that is the bold font. Or say a T1 coming here, somebody mentioned that the T1 is a bit confusing. Those kind of things do stick out because your mind every single time is trying to assess from zero. Oh, what does this mean? Oh, what does this mean? Because after 30 days is when you're going to look at it again. But some of these apps, and like, you know, other examples, like your car's dashboard, for example, right? In your dashboard, there are so many in the instrument cluster, there are so many signals, so many things that are going on. There's I think three lights, there is fuel gauge, there is temperature, there's so many things, but your eyes are focused only on two or three things, right? That is what it means, what the eye sees. Although you're looking at everything, that doesn't mean that your brain is going to perceive that. After a point, most of these things go blank. For me personally, this 27, this 15767 absolutely is blank. When I'm actually scrolling the screen, I don't see it. I literally don't, because my brain has kind of thought that, hey, this is completely irrelevant to me, I'm not going to look at it. So that is a very important thing that I don't know if how to get that point. But if you speak to users of such products, which on a day-to-day basis use, in fact, the next challenge, if we do it on Google Calendar, Nishit, I think this is a very important point, right? There are certain things that a first-time user or a new user will see immediately and say, oh, this is like, I remember I opened Google Calendar and I saw that, you know, big Google Meet or CTA, and that was very jarring for me. But I'm pretty sure
Absolutely.
to people who use it every day in their office, that is now okay, that's fine, it's all right, I know what's going to happen next. So that is very important when you're looking at such products, which are, you know, everyday kind of product. Every morning somebody's going to open, like for example, WhatsApp. WhatsApp in iOS has this call functionality up top. It's very irritating, but it really, to me, it really doesn't matter, right? Because over a period of time, I know where my eyes need to be and I know what is important to my eyes. Human psychology, I don't know if I can cover. It's a very important point. Slightly tangential from the problem statement, and I think you need to look at Robinhood, and I'll share those articles. Maybe that's how we can have the conversation, because it'll be a bit long, or maybe on the weekend we can do this. The thing that Zerodha has is it has a responsibility. It has a responsibility to all investors in India, and we had this discussion yesterday, right? Should a broker actually get in and get involved and give kind of financial advice, so to speak? Should it actually involve itself or let users do what they want? Well, this is one player, and you should read about this case study. There's several actually on this. Now everybody's writing about it. But what Robinhood did and did not do that actually led to GameStop becoming, you know, depends on which lens you're looking at from. But the fiasco that it led to, and it was not just a case of GameStop actually. There were issues much before that as well. And Robinhood was known to have the best user experience, and yet it led to events that were good for business, that is Robinhood, but bad for investors. There were cases of suicide. So people did not know that they were making so many commitments. They made those commitments, and we are not even talking about F&O trades and all of those. That is where the things, you know, get real, and people actually have no ways of paying money back. And these apps, although they are just apps to us, it is at the end of the day money, and it is up at the day end of the life. It is at the end of the day about lives. So Zerodha has a responsibility, and it's really nice that Nitin has a kind of a balanced view on how to go. At least that's what it is right now. We cannot say how things change, but he has a very balanced view. And a problem statement on, if you see on social also where I posted, is not so much about you know, long term, short term, and all of that. It is because of his stated goal that he doesn't want people to overtrade, because the minute you start overtrading, you end up losing. That is for sure. That is a given, and it has been proven over so many years. Unless you are an absolute expert at day trading, most people are not. So most people should actually stay away from it. And that is why Zerodha, being an app which was traditionally day trading. So if you see, all these indicators are day trading indicators, right? Hence, it is a difficult challenge to solve, largely because most of the audience is day traders, right? So that human psychology element actually comes through, and this today's PNL, those kind of things, nudges that are there are actually negative on the human brain, and they end up taking decisions that they normally would not take.